James.
Dana, it's really late.
I know. I just needed to talk to you. It's happening again. It's really bad. I was so scared I didn't know what to do.
Do you remember the breathing techniques Dr. Woodstein showed you?
They don't help. They never have. James, he doesn't care about me. Woodstein doesn't care. He just says it's a stressful period. And it's not. The medication doesn't help. Something I shouldn't have done. It's really bad.
Dana.
It's really bad.
If you start writing with blood on the walls again, I have to call an ambulance. Where are you going?
I don't know where I am. I don't know where I am. It's really bad. The tall man. He was here. I saw him. He's real. I saw him by the river in Green Hill. He was standing on the other side and he was smiling. Death was creeping up his teeth. And he saw me looking right at him. And he whispered, and I couldn't hear what he said, but the wind carried it. He said he was going to take my vocal cords and drown them in the river. That I would never talk again. And then he would come to me. No one would hear me scream.
I'm calling Dr. Woodstein. Where are you?
And I threw myself into the river. And I swam to the other side. And he was still there. But he was facing the road. And I took whatever I could find. So I took the lid of a trash can. And I hit him in the back of the head. And he dropped to the ground. I think it was late. I don't think anyone saw it. He started moaning and flung his arms out and asked for my help. But I knew it was all an act. And so I took the lid of the trash can and I pressed it against its neck. I pressed down so hard. They cut right through. They cut right through his neck. And he lost his head. James, the tall man, he's still here, but he doesn't have a head.